Welcome to another episode of my Motor Town playthrough. Today we are back at Liju Terminal because I just got myself a trailer hitch for my Voltex to attach the little vehicle carrier to, so we can get ourselves a new vehicle to play with. So let's go and let's see how this goes. The Voltex is a pretty strong beast and I'm a bit afraid that I'll end up just swinging the trailer around wildly like a weapon. Gonna have to see how I can control myself here. Also, I just noticed something and I'm a bit, well, a bit ashamed of that and just shaking my head at my own inability. A while ago, I made an episode with a timer attached to it, where I tested out how much time you save by using the shortcut of the mud road in Grengen or next to it. The thing is, that timer was from a website, so I needed to cut out that part of the website where I just got a stopwatch up and used it. The problem is, I still kept that whole thing active, and that means if I in the background still have my browser open, you will get a bit of an overlay from whatever site is open at that point. And yeah, usually when I start a recording, I close everything. I close down Discord, I close down my browser, I don't want anything impeding my PC performance, and I also don't want any distractions in the background. So that usually works out pretty well. However, I very often make multiple recordings one after the other, and I have the tendency to, once the first episode of a session is done, I upload it immediately just so that I don't accidentally forget about it. And that means the browser needs to be open in the background, and that means that since I forgot to turn off that stupid thing as an overlay, there's now an episode where something from a little tweet is up there, some part that really nobody can make sense of, so I'm not entirely sure what to do about it now. The episode is by no means that important. It's really just me going through my garage and actually removing a few vehicles. The vehicles in question that I got rid of were the Moosey logging version. I think that's something that everybody could have seen coming after my past few videos where I talked about wanting to remove it. I also got rid of the CUDA container because that's really a niche vehicle that would really only ever be very useful if we could use it as a flatbed as long as we don't have any container on there. But yeah, there's actually a new CUDA version coming at some point, so they seem to be set on not doing any crossover cargo thing, which is a bit of a shame because that could be a huge thing for the game. Just buying a base vehicle and then configuring it with different modules and stuff like that. But yeah, the CUDA container isn't really worth it in my opinion. I would rather take a semi truck and usually just the 40-foot trailer for that. And the last one was the Savannah, which is by no means a bad vehicle, but I don't have any use for it. And I have a lot of other vehicles that do basically the same thing, and I would rather drive those than that one, so I got rid of it. Maybe I'll get it back at some point to do some stuff with it, but for the time being I just didn't see the point there. I'm telling you guys all of this in very much detail because I am not entirely sure if I want to still publish that video. A lot of it was basically going to a shop and disassembling the more valuable tuning parts to save for later, before ultimately just getting rid of those cars. So right now, my garage has a few gaps in it. If we go to number, we will see that I think around 30 was the first one that's missing. Yeah, number 30, I think that was maybe it was the Limousy. I bought the dumpy pretty late, so that might have been that. And number 40 is the next one, that might have been the CUDA container. Oh no, I think this was the Limousin. CUDA container likely came before that. And number 47 was the Savannah. So I might just end up deleting that video because there's really not too much to talk about. And yeah, the main part about all of this is that I think I bought the last car before I sold all of those, so I'm not entirely sure if buying the Coma over here will actually fill up one of the pass numbers, so this would likely become number 30 if that is the case, or if it will just continue at number 78 or whatever I'm at right now. So that's gonna be a bit interesting. Yeah, I should have maybe left with a bit more space. I made a slight miscalculation here. But yeah, we are going to buy it and put it on the trailer. Another thing that I'm not entirely sure if I talked about that during that video, and we could just load on the next one. Yeah, no thanks, I think I'm good with one for the time being. When it comes to the in-game vehicle names, I don't know if I talked about this in my update video where I showed you guys the new bus or the one after, which I might now not be uploading anymore. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure if I should be calling the vehicles by their in-game name or by the name of their real-life counterpart. I know that for myself, with something like GTA, where, I mean, the in-game vehicle names were pretty much well known at that point, and they weren't one-to-one recreations of real-life vehicles anyways, I never liked if people called them by the real-life names. But with something like this, I feel like the in-game name is a bit more niche and might not be something that everybody knows, and I'm actually forgetting something really important here that I want to do. So let's turn this thing around, just demolish one of the stone walls where you wasn't going to stop me, because I want to buy a property over here. That's for teleportation purposes, especially if I want to go to the nearby lumber mill. Yeah, I'm definitely a good driver in this game. Flawless. And yeah, that's my new plot over here. I hope we get more housing options and especially more furniture. I have so many undecorated plots right now because of... I mean, we don't have many regular houses, there's only two options for that. And then there's of course the sandstone houses, which are nice ones, but I don't really like putting them into the middle of a neighborhood like this. I would rather have something that fits in well with everything around it. And for that, we don't have that many options. And yeah, for furniture, I've kind of given up on it because it feels like I got maybe two options for most of the stuff, and that's about it, and that's really not that interesting for me. I would rather like to have a few more available. Yeah, anyways, when it comes to the vehicle names, calling them by their in-game name or by just something like the Mini Cooper look-alike or the Hilux analog, whatever, let me know what you guys prefer. I'm open to suggestions on that matter. I'm not entirely sure what I should be doing here myself. I mean, I don't even know all the real-life names for everything, especially when it comes to buses and all of that. I recently got told by one of the modelers that actually the Lilliput is a real-life bus that has been used in some cities around Europe. I know that it, I looked it up and it's actually been used in Rome, or it used to be used there, in some roads that are just not suitable for full size buses. And it's also electrical in real life, that's the important thing. So yeah, it would be interesting having something like that in game as well. I mean, they have some electrical engines, why not make another one for that bus? And okay, at this point I guess they would need to do multiple ones so you get some upgrade options. But that would be fun and slightly different. Don't know about the whole loading situation at that point, but yeah. I'd be happy to find out. So we're just gonna bring this one back to Jiju and hopefully in one piece. I wonder if I can hit something hard enough with this so that even though I step down, the car will fly off. I mean, the taxi livery is basically, it's very close to a crash test version. It's not that far off, so we might as well, I guess. No, I don't really want to. I'm tempted, but I shouldn't. You know what? I'll just get there as fast as I can, and everything that happens on the way, it just happens. If we can get some useful information from that in the process, then that's a plus. If not, then we might learn something through not getting anything interesting to see. Oh, this is going to be spicy. Oops! I'm also currently planning on having another series start rather soon. If I can find a good spot for recording, I might actually get the first video out before this one is published. Not anything Motortown related, but hopefully something that some people would tune into. I've recently taken a liking to the Devil May Cry video games again, and I would be interested to maybe make a let's play on the first one. Well, it's a bit of a special place in my heart. But we'll have to see about it. I've been kinda procrastinating on that one for a month or so now, maybe. Oh shit, he's getting me here. There are some spots where the police doesn't know how to get to, and this is sadly not one of them. But yeah, the reason I'm buying the Coma today doesn't even have to do anything with any events, although it has been a popular event car in the past. I've always been a bit split on the super lights. They are a handful, and you need to fight the car as much as you fight the track, and sometimes that's not all that fun. What the hell are you doing there? But with the whole aero upgrade thing, I want to give this one another look and see if Return of Mini Cooper is now back on the menu. It used to be pretty much undrivable in the past. Okay, paint scheme 13. Mr. Bean car. This is another one of those things where I wish we could just paint the body below it, because having so many options that are pretty much redundant is a bit weird. Could also give us the option to paint the top part ideally. Although I think those things work kind of differently. To have decal paintable, it would basically need to be part of a car itself, instead of like texture that's being pulled onto it. I don't know if there's an option to paint this like a decal, but it would be really interesting if there was. But yeah, a lot of basically redundant options, and now we can actually paint the body. Let's paint it black. Fully black, can't even look inside. That's kind of a look, but I Like having a bit of transparency. Decals, I'm not gonna be bothering about those today. Also, I don't know if I talked about this in a video that I'm actually going to be publishing, but yeah, I'm a bit sorry when it comes to some of the videos that I'm making, that they are recorded so far in advance that by the time I publish them, sometimes the thing that I'm talking about isn't even up to date anymore. Sometimes I notice a bug or something pointed out, and by the time that video releases, another update came out and fixed that bug, thankfully, but always feels like a bit of a weird thing to still be pointing at it in my videos at that point. But that's just how it goes sometimes. Okay, I'm gonna buy it. I'm not sure if I'm going to enjoy it, but I think I should try. And we definitely need something more than 4 speed for this one. Final drive ratio, I'm gonna keep it like that. It's likely horribly off in one way or the other. Racing LSD. That sounds like something completely different from what it's supposed to be. And better brake pads. I don't need to install higher brake power. I mean, I can do, but I think it will result in a front flip. But I'm all here for that. Suspension, entire roll bar, let's go with 50% more in front. Stiffer springs up front, maybe 300%. And yeah, the rear should likely get something at least slightly stiffer than stock. Good dampers are in order. Suspension ride height. How low do we want to go? I don't think this is a good idea, but maybe like 4 centimeters. And well, let's buy a few more of them. Just for later. Wheel spacers, I think we want to go all the way out. And back in the day, people used to actually avoid this because this is adding extra weight and I usually want to keep things as light as possible. Although I feel that some people are forgetting that vehicles themselves, even if you uninstall everything, which you can't even do, but if you could, it would still weigh a few hundred kilograms. So there is a default weight, but sadly the game doesn't really bother trying to show you guys what that is. Need to go to motortown.info for that. Okay, gotta be careful because some of these wheels are actually wider. I mean, this is looking kinda sick. But I also want something light, so Duke is definitely too heavy. I mean, it might be the Zega or Zaga, whatever wheels. Or N4GT, I think that works as well. Let's buy a few of them. Could also go Fortum, I guess, but they are pretty much identical in width. So aerodynamics. Now let's see what this one can do. Little front lip, a bit more drag, but also decent amount of downforce. No front spoiler, no different bonnet. Two types of fenders, 10 kilogram for a slightly more modest fender, but we need the white one. Adding a bit of drag, but also downforce, so that's nice. 50 kilograms though, so yeah, that's a bit heavy. I mean, I talked about this before today, but always keep in mind that this is a really light vehicle, so yeah, while it's not like only the parts have weight, this is kind of adding a lot potentially. And I can't even see it through here, and I think we don't need it at all. Now we get a bit more downforce for no added drag, so might as well take it. I think this is also changing the... Oh. Yeah, somebody should maybe redo the pipe a little bit. That's a minor issue. Just gonna make a screenshot real quick. Rear spoiler, just a little spoiler lip. Actually reducing the drag, but only adding a bit of downforce. And we can usually use both this and the wing, so we might as well get both at the same time. Yeah, they don't seem to interfere with each other. Adding a lot of drag, but also really nice downforce. So finally, these parts actually do something positive for the car instead of just weighing it down. Do we need anything else here? I mean, this is kinda cool. So, sure. A bit thick for a sticker, but I'll take it. Don't care for a taxi license, don't care for a trailer hitch, but I mean, we could. Okay, it's coming from the bumper, not from the exhaust. I thought for a moment it would be coming out straight off the exhaust and then going up, which would be slightly weird. But yeah, no, we now have a new car, and you know what, let me quickly despawn it and spawn it back in just to see where it is. Okay, it's number 78, so it's not going to fill up any pass numbers anymore. Fair enough. So if you, for example, like I did at the start of this playthrough, if I sell my first car and then buy another one, that's going to get the number 1. But if I get number 2 and 3 and then sell my first car, the next one is still going to be number 4. And I respect that. And yeah, you can already see just how much the rear goes up when I'm braking. So if I'm doing something like this, I don't know what's the full requirement. Getting a spoiler might actually make it worse, but you should be, or you, at least you were able to increase your brake pressure until the point where it would just flip the car over. Might be a bit situational, but we have the full brake power. I think I need a longer final drive ratio. So let's go down to 3.73. And just use that. Also, if you really want to see that episode, where I went through the cars again and all my vehicles, trying to figure out which one I wanted to get rid of, let me know, because right now, with that weird thing going on at the bottom of the screen for the entire recording, I don't think I'll be doing that. I don't think I'll be publishing it. It's uploaded and everything, but I really noticed way too late for that. But yeah, this thing is handling pretty well. God. He said and immediately died. Of death. But yeah, spicy as ever, but maybe a bit more controllable. Definitely needs a far longer final drive ratio. This thing is definitely faster than what it can do right now. Or at least it's able to be faster. Boink. Okay, let me quickly reset my buses, because that's not going to leave me alone otherwise. And yeah, we are definitely making good money again. 10k for the double Olle. 2.8k for the one driving through the desert, what do you expect? 4.5 for Terminal Express, yeah, that's always a bit slower, but it also used to be a bit more full. And these ones, as per usual, the city buses are just killing it. And thankfully, only killing it and not their passengers. That would be bad for business. I don't know what I'm talking about. So let's go for 3.08. And let's see if we can maybe test this thing out on the highway. I immediately got some damage in again. Also, keep an eye on the fuel gauge. I think that one is going to drain out rather quickly. Yeah, I don't. What the hell is that guy doing on my side of the road? Now they are really coming for me. Yeah, I don't think this one is going to have that much range. They're likely very limited with how far I can go without a fuel stop. But you are going to get there quickly. I've seen people tune it to 300 kilometers per hour before. I don't think that would include any aero. I think at this point I might just get a 1-to-1 final drive ratio and work from there. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. But yeah, I think at this point, ultralight inline 4 division should be a bit more manageable now. There's definitely been a few vehicles that can now make it into V8 territory, which were absolutely terrifying beforehand. And there are a few vehicles that could be driven reasonably with a V12 engine, which could now use a stronger V12. But yeah, this thing, absolutely terrifying. A bit more manageable, but that's really not saying something. It's going from 0.5% control to maybe 1.5 or 2.5 or something. Okay, I know what I'm doing. And this is, I mean, shouldn't this give me like a top speed of 600 kilometers per hour? I really wish there was something more to the top range. This is very limiting. I would like to have something like 2.5, 2.2, 2.0. But yeah, I think this is going to be way too long and everything else is going to be too short. Yeah. You immediately see that something is not working out well. This might as well be one of the torque converters now instead of an actual gear transmission. Maybe I should try that. Not even going for any 5-gear transmission or anything like that. Just torque conversion all the way. Yeah, we're now almost as fast in first gear as in sixth beforehand. Jesus Christ, I tried avoiding that guy, but he just kept sneakily going into my lane. Screw you. I could have maybe tried going around the outside, but I was committed trying to make it on the inside. And there's things you don't go back on. But yeah, I'm no professional setup maker or anything like that. I'm not that well reversed or whatever in tuning cars. But I think the final drive ratio might be a bit too long in this one. It's just a hunch. Also, depending on how the gear ratios work out for the transmissions, I think in order to get a good one, we might actually have to go back to a 5-speed transmission. Let's see. That's the usual welcome, like bow your head in shame, or almost make your car flip. So let's see, I could try 2.73, but it's not gonna be long enough. Transmission, we have EV speed 1, that might be interesting. But yeah, this is going down to 0.9. So maybe the HM6 might be better, going down to 0.67. 5-speed goes down to 0.76. Yeah, I might have to try this one. Or just go for a torque converter and see where we end up with that. But yeah, this is now far more reactive. But likely once again too short for our purposes. Yeah, 215, and then redlining is definitely not making the best use of our potential here. I hope there's nobody coming towards me. Holy smokes, that front tire grip. Would be interesting to see an all-wheel drive update for this car. But yeah, at least by now it's at least, well, remotely controllable, at least. Don't know how often I said that, but I thought it would be good adding it one more time, at least. But yeah, this is a beast. At least. Fucking hell! I can't stop. Somebody stop me, please. I'm not saying it anymore. It wouldn't fit there. Okay, yeah, besides burning my tires and also the fuel like nothing. Let's see, I wanna try this one again. But with a torque converter this time around. I think these ratios might be good for each other. I don't think they are. Yeah, definitely don't think so. I mean, when it comes to the torque conversion thing, shouldn't this give me a range of ratios that it can go, like from this one to that one at maximum? Because just seeing that it's like a 1.00 ratio is not really doing much for me. So let's go to 3.08. I think that's going to definitely be detrimental on the top speed. If I'm understanding everything here correctly, we are now going to go slower with our ultimate top speed than before. Also, I might have to go into Gangyang now because, well, I need a gas station. Yeah, we're definitely slower in top speed, and it doesn't really help initial acceleration. Not having to shift is pretty nice because that always takes a bit of time, although with this car is not quite as much. Yeah, low fuel warning, go figure. And this is what happens if you hit a bump. Good that we tried it, I wasn't sure about how much it would kill me. Okay. Back in downtown. Next bump, this was not as bad as it could have been. There's still a weird suspension glitch where it just ends up hyping itself up to a point where it just throws the car around. But yeah, this is definitely more controllable than before. I wish I had a better way of like testing all of this. I could theoretically try and go back and forth between the testing version and the live version and build up the same car. I don't really want to do that, and honestly I'm not a good enough driver to get much data out of it. There are definitely better people for that. And I heard most people say that overall aerodynamics is worth the extra weight. But I also heard people say that basically the cars are only the weight of their components and not like a core chassis and unremovable stuff weight. So yeah, there are differing opinions on stuff. And yeah, I think I'm going to be trying this one here. It's also a bit lighter, which might help. And we are going back to 2.73. I should maybe just do all of this at Anson all the time. Having a straight piece of highway right next to it is definitely helping. Also, it comes with both a repair shop and a gas station. But I think this is the last time I'm going to try going across the island for today. Just seeing how fast we can go, but I think we should now be a bit quicker. And the torque converter might also do its thing to help out here. But yeah, just having more transmission options and that kind of stuff would be cool. This is definitely quite a bit longer now. We are not even in final gear. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit! They are not really getting there. So I guess the HM6 transmission is the one to go for here. I could even go up a bit in the other numbers to just make it a bit shorter again. I never know how to call it when it comes to final drive ratio. Because the further down the number you go, if it's smaller, if it's like 1 to 1 instead of 2.72 to 1, then it's definitely smaller number, but it gives you higher top speed and all of that. But if I'm going more for acceleration, I might actually get a decent top speed out of it. You know what, because that was just a really botched attempt. Let's do it again. I wanna see what we can make over here in terms of top speed. Maybe I should just try reading the graphs at the tuning shop. But I don't know if there's any graph for speed and acceleration or something like that. I've recently picked up Screwdrivers, which is a game where you can build your own car from scratch and also do a lot of stuff with transmission and that kind of thing. So yeah, this is really not helping here. I would need something where this thing isn't changing anymore, so it's not really taking this into account. This would really now be interesting if the bottom would say something like kilometers per hour, and you should be able to see your different gears in the graph and that kind of thing. That would really help figuring out which one to go for. Also, one thing that I absolutely hate about this game is I'm not doing anything right now apart from steering. But just because it's in gear, it's going to just work off. And that's kind of annoying. Either need to turn off the engine, pull the brake, or I mean the handbrake, or go into neutral. But when idling, a lot of the cars, especially the lighter ones, they're just going to roll off somewhere. I mean, it's not really rolling, but yeah. Okay, that was maybe a bit low in the RPM range. But we are pulling ourselves back up again. Also pulling up the hill, which is not to be underestimated. Yeah, I don't know if I need 6D at this point. I might as well go down one. And yeah, for full top speed testing, I need the highway. This is not working. But hey, good way to sink some money down the drain, I guess. Especially towards the repair shop. To undo what I just did to the car and the components. But yeah, this is going to be it for me for this video. Don't know what I'll be doing with this car overall, but I'm happy that V12 Mini Cooper is now back on the menu, at least potentially. Back in the day, before aerodynamics and everything, it used to kill you even more than it does right now. And trust me, that is possible. So this might be just a little fun thing to whip out every now and again. But yeah, that's gonna be it for me. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and till next time, don't build up stupidly strong cars that you cannot control. Be safe. And till then, bye bye.